If you're a homeowner whose property has been reassessed, you don't want to move too far from that television set right now. We're talking to Bob Pierce, and Bob and I have now been joined by two other gentlemen. I want to welcome, first of all, Mike Suley, the Assistant Chairman of the Assessment Board of Appeals. Your office is bustling these days. And George Donatelli, and you are not an assessor, you are an appraiser.
That is correct.
Oh, you're the guy we want to get to also.
A mass appraiser.
Okay, all right. Okay, Bob, where are we going to go with these guys? I mean, we painted the picture. By the way, who knows how many houses have been reassessed in Allegheny County this year?
Well, first of all, Allegheny County hired a company called Sabre, and George works for that company. Their job is to assess every house in Allegheny County, so it's a tremendous job, and everybody who's watching your program who lives in a house, his people are going to be knocking on their door in the next couple of years if
between
they haven't
now,
already.
Between now and when?
January 1, 2001.
Oh, so if you haven't had your property reassessed, come up close to the television set because your day will come. Okay. All right.
It's coming as we speak. I mean, they're knocking on people's doors right now.
And it's painless.
All right. George, I hear that it's, what is this drive-by situation where you drive by, you take a look at a house, and you go, ha-ha, that one looks like we should maybe up it a little bit?
Those are called drive-by appraisals, and we don't do those at all. They are verboten in our business.
But they used to be done.
Well, I can't talk about what
you
used to
happen. You do not do any drive-by appraisals?
Absolutely not. We're collecting data very carefully and analyzing it, and three appraisers will look at a value before it's ever put on the tax roll.
Okay, Mike, what's the percentage of increase that we're seeing? I mean, how much are these assessments going up?
Actually, the assessments over the last 4 or 5 years haven't increased that much. The taxes have, the millage rates have, the school districts do the taxing, Eleanor. But the assessment board, it's important to note that the assessment board does not tax. We set the market value for the assessments that the taxing bodies use. But over the last 4 years, I would say probably 90% of the properties in Allegheny County have not been reassessed.
Mm-hmm. Well, the other 10% or more have been assessed 30 to 40 to 50% in the last 3 or 4 years. Now, these fellows did not do that, but I'm saying as people had appeals 3 or 4 years ago, my house, for example, doubled. In 1996, my real estate assessment doubled, which meant my taxes went, you know, 100% increase. Some people had a 300% increase. That's why we had this major problem in the lawsuits that resulted in the Allegheny County saying, okay, let's just hold our breath for 2 or 3 years, hire a professional to come in and reassess it and do it right.
Okay, are we in better shape now, Bob, than we were in the past as far as having a system that is a little more fair, a little more equitable?
Well, in my opinion, you're going to be in worse shape because the fairer the system is, the more equitable it is, the higher your real estate taxes are going to be. Because most of the houses,
you're getting a little chuckle from this end of the table.
If they do their job right, they're going to raise most people's taxes. And until we get off this real estate tax, we're going to find out that they're going to be raising people's taxes by doing a good job.
But
that's
not necessarily true.
Okay, come on.
Bob, we're finally going to get people assessments correct. And in fact, taxes may go down for a large number of people in Allegheny County. I agree with you that if we approach market value, that'll be the first time in a lot of years when we get to market value. But if the jurisdictions roll back their millages like they should,
that's a big if.
Then taxes, in fact, will only go up on a third of the properties. A third will come down and a third will stay about the same. And that's based on 30 years of experience in this business.
I have one comment. I live in Mount Lebanon. Will the Mount Lebanon School District accept a 50% increase in their school budget? by us raising the assessments? I hope the answer is no. And I hope that there's a mechanism in place in Harrisburg that will prevent the school districts from taking this tax windfall.
But as we speak,
we don't tax.
There is no mechanism like that.
Right.
And most school districts have plenty of legitimate ways to spend money. I mean, if the money's there, the teachers get a raise, they have driver's ed, they have a new football field. I mean, there are lots of legitimate ways where a school district can spend money. So that's,
well,
that's
Bob,
my fear.
You know, here on AgeWise, we really are advocates for older adults. And we're talking about a lot of older adults whose taxes are going up to the point that they may no longer have a home where they can live for the rest of their days. They don't have any kids in school. They just want to live out their years in their home. Now, they say, gee, this doesn't sound fair. I'm going to appeal this. Now, Bob took us through a little bit earlier the process. It finally comes, right.
It comes in front of Mr. Suley.
You're the judge. Okay. What do you end up, how do you make that judgment?
It's a painful process for me because I am bound by law to perform my statutory duty. I have to follow the law. And the law is I can't discriminate on who lives in the house. I have to place a value on the property based on the market value of the property. Not, I can't use as part of my criteria what the income is. Again, my job is just to place a value on the property. We assess property, we do not assess people.
All right, what about the income? Is there any break given to low income adults?
Yes, and this is the part about my job that I enjoy. Most people come in if they're senior citizens. I ask them if they're familiar with any of the discount programs. Many times they are not. Allegheny County has a program. If you make $15,000 a year or less, they will roll back the assessment to 1993 levels. Now that would be on your Allegheny County tax bill. So there's a discount available there. If you're a resident, an owner in the city of Pittsburgh, and you make $20,000 a year or less, Eleanor, you get a discount and it's rolled back to the 1993 assessment. So there are programs out there to help people, and I'm glad I have the opportunity today to make people know about that. They can contact the assessment office and we can guide them in the right direction on these programs.
Okay, Bob, from your office to Mike's bench, what goes on in the meantime?
Well, I think the first thing that's going to happen is an assessor is going to come and knock on their door and is going to want to be invited in to look at the interior of the house.
Okay, can I interrupt?
It's a data collector. Excuse
okay.
me.
Now, how do you, you know, again, we have a lot of elderly widows out there.
Yes.
We are constantly hearing,
yes,
don't open your door to anyone.
Yes.
Do you call first? How do you identify yourself? And should I let you in my home?
Well, first of all, yes, you should let me in your home, because I think it's to your advantage, contrary to what others might say. I believe it's to your advantage to let me in, to show me the interior of your home so that I have some idea about the condition of the property, and most especially to know if there are any problems with the interior of the home that might in fact lower the value of the property. For instance, a leaky basement, poor room layout, you know, four bedrooms and one bath. Those kinds of things now are important in valuation, mm-hmm, and the only way we can get that information is to come through your house with you or stand at your front door and ask you those questions and have you tell them to me.
But it is the homeowner's discretion to determine whether they will let
Absolutely.
You enter. Okay, and you say it is a good idea because otherwise you just take the footprint of the house, right?
Yeah, no, I don't necessarily agree with that. I mean, I understand where George is coming from, but in my opinion, if you have a nice house, and your furniture is nice and you're a good housekeeper and you don't have any major problems, I would not let that person in because they're going to look at your nice house, the interior, the carpets, and human nature is going to be, gee, this is a pretty nice house.
Not at all. Well, I don't care about the collections or the antiques.
A human being is taking that information.
And it's very, very objective, the information that we take.
All right, Mike, you're the judge. What do you say? Mike, come on, you're the judge.
We scrutinize the property at the appeal hearing. Everything they're talking about is before the appeal hearing. So at the appeal hearing, I want to know what is in the house. If I don't know ahead of time, then I have to assume.
And Eleanor, I want to know about the interior of the house, how many bedrooms do you have? Mm-hmm. How many bathrooms do you have? What does your basement look like? Okay. What's the finish?
All right, Mike, what do they bring before you? Do they bring photographs?
Sometimes they do, yeah.
Because which is a good idea.
A picture is worth a thousand words.
Sure. Okay.
Now I know what your home looks like from the outside.
Okay, all right.
That helps.
Let's sum this up rather quickly. You get the reassessment notice. You decide to appeal it. Bob, you take a lot of these cases, again, on a contingency basis. You will take the homeowner and you will actually go with them to the appeal hearing?
Or sometimes I go without them if they can't come, and then I bring photographs. Or the homeowner can come, you know, alone. I mean, they're very respectful of people that don't have a lawyer. They'll treat you well.
Yeah.
But you got to be careful. Take pictures of the bad stuff, not the good stuff.
Okay.
Again, you're an advocate.
Okay.
You're trying to say it's worth less than what they're saying it's worth. So you got to be careful.
Final words from you.
Well, your argument when you come before me or any of the board members should not be what your taxes are. It should be, what is the value of my home? You walk in and you prove that your house is worth less than what the county assessment board says it is.
Okay. And George, what kind of identification do your people have when they knock on my door?
Everyone has a badge. All of the cars are clearly marked.
Okay.
All of our data collectors have pagers, and can call the office. We'll send back a secret message on the pager that only the property owner and our office know.